Enterprise. I'm sitting with Jody from AARP, and you probably don't think about venture capital and startups and retirees and aging people. However, as Jody and I have been talking about, it's a huge, vast area of unexplored opportunity, and I think not enough entrepreneurs. The entrepreneurs are always looking for those areas of need that they can turn into areas of profit, but they're not looking enough at this particular segment in the market.
So think about this, right? 100 million people over 50 and growing, $2.3 trillion in annual disposable income. In Washington, they call that a problem and a cost. Entrepreneurs call that opportunity. What we are trying to do is trying to make sure that entrepreneurs and the venture community and the entire ecosystem understand what the scale and scope of that opportunity is.
And I'm sure you're probably also helping them have some understanding of the needs of that community. What are some of those needs that you see that are not being met that could be met by technology?
So some of those needs are, for example, aging in place, right? If you ask people what is the number one thing they want, it is to not leave their homes, right? Nobody wants to go in a nursing home or anything like that. And frankly, even if they wanted to, there's a mismatch between the numbers and the available beds. So people want to age in place. To age in place effectively, technology plays a key role. Our assessment is that is potentially a $20 billion industry unto itself that doesn't exist yet.
And we're talking about sensors, we're talking about two-way video communication. We did see and we talked about a lot of these really cool products at the demo we had last fall that were all about aging in place. What's another area of opportunity that you can think of?
So in addition to that, 80% of the leisure travel in US is done by people over 50. So is kayak a technology for everybody, or is 80% of it potentially a product for people over 50? Is Expedia a product for whom, etc.? So when people look at, I want to finally take that trip I always wanted to take, learn about those things I always wanted to learn, there's huge opportunity in those types of areas.
And you know what, as you're speaking about this, I'm thinking, you know, a lot of the venture capitalists that I know are also in that age group. Do you think that they are focusing on or avoiding that age group themselves?
Definitely. So my message to the venture capital community is, if you think about the metaphor of chaos theory, which is that the tsunami originates with the fluttering of the wings of the butterfly. I'm focused on what are those fluttering wings? And the fluttering wings come down to adding one single question to your list of diligence questions, and that is, what's your 50 plus strategy? So if the venture capitalists start to ask that question, they'll start to think about answers to that question.
And you know, those 19-year-old entrepreneurs sitting in front of them it hasn't crossed their minds.
Exactly.
That would probably change a lot of things about how we build technology.
Exactly. The first time that question is asked, it'll take a startup by surprise.
Well, let's hope it starts getting asked a lot more. Thank you, and Jody, so much for tracking. I'm sorry.
The second time it's asked, the question will go viral, because it will be, if you get in front of that VC, you better have an answer to this question.
That's a really excellent
And that
point.
Leads to innovation.
Absolutely. Well, thank you so much for chatting with us, Jody. And thank you, you know what? Thank you for changing the way we think and for helping us to broaden our perspectives on technology and culture.
Thanks, Jody.
Thank you guys for watching. We'll see you more soon.
Great.